So we looked at finding areas under the curve given cutoff values. Now what we want to do is switch that order and look at finding cutoff values. So basically finding values for x given area under the curve. So this is going to be the case where we want to find x, but we know what our probability is, or our percentage. So how this can come through is with the wording of percentile. And sometimes they'll tell you percentage above, percentage below, but this wording percentile always describes area to the left. So it's a special word that has a direction connected to it. So like in this graphic to the right-hand side, this is the 70th percentile. It's this cutoff value that divides this lower 70% with this upper 30%. And basically, if you have, say, I said the 60th percentile, I could immediately make a picture with this with using a bell-shaped curve. And a good marker is halfway in between is your 50%. If this is making an area to the left of 60%, we need to move a little further to the right and have this cutting point that you have some x value such that 60% of the data is to the left-hand side. So look out for this word. It's telling you how percentages distribute. It's just based on percentage to the left. So in the last section, we talked about how when you're in GeoGebra, you could be editing these values for x, and so then you could get out your probability on the right-hand side of the equation. Now what we're going to be doing is editing this right-hand side. That's where you can edit your percentages so that if we know we had a 60th percentile, what we could do is type in 0.6 over there, as long as we're moving to the left-hand side. So you need to match up direction and then match up your area. And then it's where x is. That value is going to adjust based on what you plug in. So let's look at some examples. We're going to go back to rainfall, which is where we had a normal distribution, mean of 40, standard deviation of 8. And let's start with this lowest 10%. So lowest 10%, that's going to be to the left-hand side. All your low values are to the left, high values are to the right. So lowest 10% is equivalent to the 10th percentile. So what we want to do is find this dividing point where there's some x value that's going to cut our graph at that point, and that's going to leave 10% to this left-hand side. And if you know area to the left, you always know area to the right as well. I could think of this as having a larger area of 90%, and you could really use either one within GeoGebra to get your value. But let's go ahead with using that percentage they gave us. So what this is going to look like in terms of our probability notation, we're saying the probability of x being less than or equal to, and then we don't know what the number is, but if we're less than or equal to that value, which is creating this area to the left-hand side, then our probability has to be 0.1. So in GeoGebra, what I'm going to do is edit our mean. So we'll have a mean of 40, standard deviation of 8, and then we want to go to the left-hand side. So we're going to switch to our left hand, and then we're going to edit the other side of the equation. So where we see that 0.8413, which is our area, we actually want that area to be 10%. So with that, our x value changed to that 29.7476, which will be our solution. So what this would equate to is the 10th percentile of rainfall is at 29.7476 inches. Or you could say, you could use that lowest 10%. You could say the lowest 10% of rainfall in Portland is below 29.7476 inches. That works too. Either way. All right, this next one is telling us about this highest 5%. Now, highest 5% is describing our right-hand side. So this is saying on the right-hand side of our graph, there's this cutting point such that we have this upper 5%, which equates to a lower 95% since it has to add up to 1. So that's where this is the same as the 95th percentile. But if we want to use that percentage they give us, what we're saying is the probability that X is larger than or equal to some number, there's a 5% chance of that occurring. So to get that number out in GeoGebra, what we need to do is switch our direction so that we're going to the right-hand side now, and then we need to edit that area so that it's 5%. And that gives a 53.1588. So the highest 5% of rainfall is above 53.1588 inches. All right. And then this last one wants a middle 50%. So what this is gonna look like is we're gonna go below and above, and it should be more symmetric than that, but basically in a symmetric way, we wanna cut out this 50% in the middle here, which means we're going to have two x values. We're going to have this lower x value, which I'll call x1, and this upper value, x2. Now, if we go into GeoGebra at this point, and I set my area to be stuck in between two values, notice that it locks. The area, I can't edit the area here. It's stuck. And why that is because this area of 50% can happen all over the place. If I start dragging this around, it's that I could create these different areas on all different points, and that it doesn't assume it's symmetric about the middle. It's that 50% can happen in the tails or kind of skewed in the middle. So with that, it doesn't let you edit the center. But what we can do is get kind of creative with the tails in order to find that middle area. So if we have 50% in the middle, then we should have 50% in these two tails, which means we'll have 25% to this left-hand side and 25% to this right-hand side. So what we could do is look at these areas separately to find x1. We can find where's this cutoff point such that the area to the left is 0.25. So for x1, we can look at less than or equal to some number, and that area should be a 0.25. So with that in GeoGebra, we can work with that. We can work with single tails. So if we set a left-hand side and a 0.25, that's a 34.6041. So x1 is at 34.6041. And then we can do the same thing for x2, where we can find where is the area above some point, that 25%. So looking for probability x is larger than some number, should be 25%. So in GeoGebra, we can get out x2 by plugging in that upper area. So area to the right, change that to a 0.25, and there's a 45.3959. So the middle 50% of rainfall is between 34.6041 and 45.3959 inches. And you could double check this works out in GeoGebra by editing your lower and upper bound. So say we did want area between, have a lower bound of 34.6041, upper bound of 45.3959, and it's nice and symmetric, and it does give you that area of 50% in between those two values. But given area between two values, you need to use the tails in order to find your cutoff values.